Hey guys, I welcome you all to this session on how to become a data scientist in 2020. Data science has been hailed as the sexiest job of the 21st century by Harvard Business Review. But what is it that makes data science such a hot cake, and why should we learn data science to keep our career from stagnation? Well, according to LinkedIn, the data science job profile is among the top three jobs in the United States. Similarly, according to Glassdoor, the job postings for data science profile in India have grown over 500% in the last 1 year itself. So being skilled in data science is not a value add anymore, but an absolute necessity to survive in today's cutthroat competition. Now let's go ahead and understand the importance of data science. We live in a world that is inundated with data. So every trivial task that you do generates data. If you make a credit card transaction, you are generating data. If you like someone's post on Facebook, you are generating data. And well, if you upload a video on YouTube, guess what? You are generating data. Now we have this huge amount of data with us, which if utilized properly can help in boosting a company's revenue, understand customer sentiments, or even cure a disease. And this is where data science comes in. So data science basically refers to application of certain operations on top of the raw data to generate meaningful information. Now this information obtained would help us in answering questions such as what has happened in the past, what will happen in the future, and what are the steps we should take to get a desirable outcome. Now that we understand the importance of data science, let's see how much does a data science role pay. According to McKinsey, the average salary of a data scientist in the United States is $120,000 per annum and ₹10 lakh per annum in India. The best part of being skilled in data science is you're not just limited to one job profile. You would have openings for the roles of data scientist, data analyst, financial analyst, business analyst, and big data engineer. So it's obvious that if you have these skills, there's a job waiting for you. Now let's see how much can an entry level, mid level, and an experienced level data scientist can earn. According to Glassdoor, someone with 0 to 3 years of experience can earn in the range of $60,000 to $120,000. A person who has 4 to 8 years of experience can earn in the range of $75,000 to $160,000. And a person with more than 10 years of experience can get paid an average salary of $200,000. Isn't this amazing? Also, since data is all pervasive, the data science roles are not just limited to one particular domain. The medical industry uses data science and analytics in a big way to improve health in a variety of ways. For instance, the use of wearable trackers to provide important information to physicians who can make use of the data to provide better care to their patients. The telecom sector also uses data collected through customer behaviors, such as voice, SMS, and social media activities to offer customized services as well as products. Automobile industry uses data analytics to help increase customer satisfaction and also implement new marketing strategies. It's not just these three sectors. Data science is used in banking, construction, retail, and a lot more sectors. Now let's have a look at the companies paying top salaries for data science experts in the United States. Facebook, Airbnb, and Microsoft are the front runners who pay a whopping $200,000 for their employees skilled in data science. And when it comes to India, it is Amazon, Fractal Analytics, and IBM who pay close to 25 lakhs per annum for the data science roles. So data science is the field to be in right now, and data scientists are the rock stars of this era. But what does it actually take to become a data scientist in 2020 or in the future years? Well, statistics and math are an integral part of data science. Thus, it's very important to be good at multivariate calculus and linear algebra. You also need to be good at a lot of statistical concepts such as measures of central tendency, measures of deviation, and you also need to be good at probability and probability distribution concepts. And a data scientist who cannot code can't really work with real life problems. Hence, you need to have some programming background to begin with. And out of all the languages, Python is the most important language for a data scientist to learn. One should have expertise with libraries such as NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn, and Scikit-learn. R is the second most important language for a data scientist to learn. It is important because R is a language which was developed by statisticians for statisticians and provides more than 10,000 packages for varied purposes such as data manipulation, data visualization, and statistical analysis. Perhaps even more important than a data scientist's ability to explain their analysis is their ability to communicate the value and potential impact of the actionable insights. The need for a data scientist to extract out and communicate what's important will never be made obsolete. So guys, I hope this helped you to understand what skills do you exactly need to become a data scientist. So start learning data science right now and get that dream job that you'd always wanted. Thank you and have a great learning ahead.